So we have three rings I just pulled out. Now, my prices reflected when I put them in. I haven't adjusted my stuff yet, and that's actually something that's on my list of things to do, which I think is another important point. When you price stuff, if no one whispers you about it, you need to be very certain that the price you have is correct to leave it at that price. So it has to be very valuable. And the way things tend to work in PoE is something that's very valuable holds its value or gets more valuable. And everything else should slowly come down in price. Because as time goes on, the upgrades that people can find or can use on their gear, that data set gets narrower and narrower. And of course, when something's tiny, that means it has to be very good in terms of PoE for gear set. There's only a couple of them, that means they're really amazing. So let's look at this first ring. Look at both of these. Okay, so now this ring, I priced, I believe, at 5 chaos. I'm looking at the tab. Now I'm going to tell you how I arrived at that conclusion. It's a two-stone ring, so that's a positive. That's the first thing I check is the base. It has 4 to 10 fizz, which I think is the third mod. Some of the rolls with fizz in particular, because they have a range, they can be, you're not sure which one it is glancing at it. I can look it up here and hopefully find it, although that's not always easy as well. Okay. Annealed is the top. Here we go. Annealed is the top fizz on rings. See, 9 to 15. I know that's the top roll. So this one that I have is 10, right? Okay, 4 to 10. So here we go, 4 to 10. This is the hone. This is like level 20, I level 28. So we're two tiers down from the top. So okay, but it's still 4 to 10. It's not bad. You'd want this. The accuracy light radius roll is total garbage. That was added to make items tougher to roll. Because I think Chris stated that item inflation, or he had a fancy word for what it was, how quickly people acquired gear, that was happening too quickly for them. The speed at which they acquired gear was happening too quickly. So they added some of these sort of trash mods that aren't bad, do something, but aren't that great. Now this has 67 evasion, which for most characters in the game either are based on evasion or IR. So that's a good roll. That's like getting free armor, basically. And most rings have at least one or two open prefixes. You don't need fizz rolls, or you don't need ES rolls for your character to work. So evasion sits in there. Now the 58 mana, that's a very high roll. I think that's second tier, and then mana regeneration, I believe, is also second tier. These are both highly desirable stats right now in today's world. So both of these together, I think, is very desirable. So these two, plus the evasion, which is a good roll, a nice secondary roll to have, and the good medium roll of fizz, and you can master life on this, which I want to confirm before I say that. And this is the great part about the master items. Oops. Cannot roll under the prefix mod. 4 to 10 fizz, mana, evasion. Okay. So you see, I didn't even look at that. So you can see how quickly. Now, I rolled a lot of rings and I quickly priced it. This is not worth 5 chaos. This is maybe a chaos. Maybe for, like, I don't know, someone's starter ring. But so this is what's changed about master pricing and master crafting. Items that this, if this one, say, didn't have the evasion, this ring didn't have the evasion, and you can master life on. Let's just say that you decided, if this had 60 life, what would my price be? That's how you have to figure things with master crafting. So if this had a spot for prefix for life, and I could put 60 life on it, what would I think this would be worth? And maybe I'd say, and this is how I did what I did last time when I priced it. Oh, maybe this is 10 chaos at the time. That's my general idea, 10 chaos, because it has middling rolls, has good mana regeneration, a decent fizz. Maybe someone would consider paying 7 to 10 chaos for it. That's how I would think about it. Rolls are okay, decent life. Maybe someone would pay that. But if you want to master life on it, costs 4 chaos. So I just did the math. Okay, if I say it's worth 10, and it costs me 4 chaos to put life on it, I don't want to take that risk of putting life on it. I hope someone searches for it. I'm prepared to negotiate for less than it's worth, because they have to go through the trouble of mastering the life on. This means, okay, I'm going to put it up for 5 chaos. And then hopefully someone says, oh, you know, I'll give you 3 chaos for it, and I'm happy. Or 2 chaos, I'm happy for that. Turns out, in my quick assessment of things, I missed that there were 3. There is an open mod, because light, radius, and accuracy is a dual mod, but it was an open suffix, so ring's not worth anything. And this is good. You need to go back and review what you've done and what you've priced and what you put up. So, for instance, I use procurement, and these tabs I have priced based on the buyout. So I put it in there and never look at it again, and then you periodically need to go through and sort of clean up. Okay, so now this chaos ring. This one, this is a little bit more direct. It has 79 life. That's the top roll inside the top mod. So right there, seeing that on almost anything confers immediate value, say 5 chaos. This isn't a rule that I use. I'm just trying to give people a general guideline that perhaps could work, since people are having trouble pricing jewelry themselves. So 79 life. Now this has a nice fire roll, that's second tier on fire res. It has a decent maximum energy shield roll. It has a lightning damage roll, 2 to 23. I'm actually not sure what that goes to in rings. I don't want to look that up now because there's a lot of damage rolls. And then 10 all attributes, which is a suffix. 10 all attributes is, I don't know, not the worst thing to get on a ring. You could get, I think it's 17 to 23 on rings. That's a very high eye level, I believe, rings that have, like, you know, 73, 74. Not sure on that, but to me, when I see something like this, attributes, not a minus, a slight plus, 2 to 23 lightning damage, that's always good. Characters that are physical based are fine with that. It has a very bad accuracy roll. That's the negative to it. But it has top life, it has chaos resist, which in this expansion, Beyond League, very important. A lot of the mobs spawn, do chaos damage, just constant chaos damage. So players that are life-based really want top life and some chaos resist. It does give you another resist, 39 fire res, and then the maximum energy shield is always helpful. It's either effective life or it goes into your mana pool through Eldritch Battery. So to me, I price now, this is probably, it was down here. I tend to go up every, you know, couple days. We have keep going up and placing the items. That's, you know, it's not really a system, but I try to organize like that. So it's over here. I probably priced this a couple of weeks ago at 10 chaos. Again, hoping that someone comes to me and says, I want this for, I don't know, who random people offer random stuff all the time. I'll give you 13 alks for that. I'd probably say, so 13 alks in my mind, I do 5 to 2 alks to chaos. So that's 4 chaos and a little bit, you know, 5 roughly. Roughly 5 chaos. So I'd say, okay, if you add in 1 chaos or 2 chaos, I'll say something. Because again, PoE is about haggling and negotiation. And then I'd take that. Now, no one's happened to whisper me about this particular ring. I've had similar rings to this sell. So sometimes it's not really about the ring itself. It's about, did anyone search for it? That doesn't mean it's necessarily less valuable, although nothing in this game has any value until someone makes an offer or purchases it. So someone might say, well, that's not really worth 3x, but if someone bought it for 3x, that's what it's worth. Now, granted, I'm a streamer. I'm not a very big streamer, but some people think that streamers have a huge advantage. This is true. I want to dispel the notion that it's not true. This is very true. But it's a double-edged sword, right? Okay, maybe I'll get someone to buy this for 8 chaos right now because I'm a streamer and they're just fine to give me money. But the other side of that that people don't talk about is someone could try to, this could be underpriced. I could have made a mistake, right? This could really be worth 3x. This one's not. But let's just say I missed something about it. I missed that you can master something on this. I could master on all res, and then now the value is much higher. Because again, all res as a stat is one of the most desirable stats because it fills all your resistances, makes it much easier to acquire different pieces of gear. And so someone will say, they see it in my 10Ks tab, it's already underpriced, and they'll go, and they know that we want to do deals and just make quick sales. I'll give you 5Ks for that. And we're just like, or 6Ks. And we're like, okay, fine. Great. It turns out it was worth 2x. So not only are they getting it a steal for 10Ks, they get whisper us a value that's less, so they're not being nice to us. And this happens to other people too. But trust me, as a streamer, people are looking to pull one over you. Always. Makes them look good, makes you look stupid. So it's a double-edged sword. So you gotta be vigilant. And if you're not a streamer, that's okay. You want to be vigilant as well because perhaps you are watching this video, you don't think you price jewelry well, and there are other people out there who really know the market. There's definitely people out there who know the market better than I do because I'm doing all sorts of other stuff with my time. There are some people who just blast trades all day. Well, I mean, he's going to know exactly what he can get for this, and if he can get it for less and then flip it, he's going to make money. That's how they make money. This is a ring that I was talking about that I was going to go to. This is a coral ring. I alked this. Now, when I look at this, given some of the things we've talked about today, it's a coral ring. So it's not a great base. But assuming we cross the threshold for something that's very valuable, wow, this has fizz damage, evasion, second life. It has well, second lightning, but it's the top roll. People are probably never going to divine this. So the roll itself can matter. A 23 chaos, which actually, unfortunately, that's the low end of the second chaos roll. I think it's 23 to 27. But these things by themselves perhaps are not too valuable. But this ring has 87 life. It's got evasion. It's got a free slot. Okay? Life, evasion, and physical damage, these are prefix mods. So it has a free suffix. So now, I could have put on all res to this. Oh, and crit chance as well. Okay. Mana regeneration, all res. What else would you want to put on? You can put on a res as well. Now, the reason I didn't do that is because, unfortunately, GGG, and I don't understand this, removing master mods, you have to have level 8 of the masters. This is a hassle. If it was level 6, I would have just mastered this already with whatever and been like, you fix it yourself if you don't like what I did. So I don't want to, I wouldn't brick it, but let's say you bought this ring and you need fire res. You don't need all res. You got tons of cold. So the all res is a bad mod. You would put the fire res on this, making this extremely valuable for you. Or vice versa with the cold. Or you're a crit-based class and you want to put the crit on because all you need is fizz, life, chaos, and crit. Well, there you go. Now I have this price for an absurd price, just absolutely absurd. I think I have 4.5x or something. Now, when I searched for rings, this is the thing we're going to do in a second here. Pricing something like this can be very difficult if you're a new player or new to the game. So you come in. This is XYZ, PoeXYZ. Everyone should be familiar with this. Very easy to use. This is the old, I'm sure the guy who designed XYZ, I forget his name. If he saw this right now, he'd be so mad that I'm not using the modern theme. I like the old theme. It's got I something wrong with my cookies. This screen's gonna go white once I search, which is unfortunate. And I'm gonna open Google Chrome because it doesn't do that there. What you need to do when you're looking for something. Here we go. Okay. What you need to do searching for an item. So this coral ring that we got.